Dear friends, we are in BCom, second year, fourth semester subject income tax. In the previous class, I have mentioned about the syllabus. As it happens in every other subject, we have 5 units in this subject also. This is the syllabus. Yesterday also I showed the syllabus. In the previous class, we have seen the syllabus. In case you missed the class, you can note down. So I have started first unit, that is introduction. In yesterday's class, in the previous class, I have started introduction. We will continue the discussion. Okay. So unit one, that is introduction, introduction to income tax. See, in our previous class, we have learned about the concept of tax. Before we enter into income tax, we have to know something about tax. What do you mean by tax? That we discussed yesterday. In the previous class, we have discussed. So one of your friends defined tax in a very good manner. Tax is a mandatory payment to the government. Mandatory means compulsory payment. Nobody can escape. That is what you mean by saying tax. Tax is a fee charged by a government. In the previous class, I have mentioned government implies it may be state government, it may be central government, or it may be local government. Okay. So these are the characteristic features of tax. In the previous class, we have discussed it is a payment in money. It is a fee charged by government. It is required by a government. A private person cannot collect a tax. Only government can collect a tax. Okay. Similarly, those who pay tax directly, they may not get benefits, but the society at large benefits from the taxpayer. Okay, that is what you mean by saying unrelatedness. So it is financial, it is mandatory, it is a compulsory payment. That tax is implemented by law. So if a person fails to pay tax, it is a punishable crime. The government will punish that person. It may be by imposing a fine, or if a serious punishment has to be given, the person will be put in prison. Okay. So similarly, taxes can be paid regularly or occasionally. In case of any incident, the government may levy. Levy means impose. So the government may collect separate tax based on the situation. If situation demands, government will impose a tax, special tax. Okay. So for any thing that it needs to be termed as tax, it has to satisfy 3 criteria, means 3 conditions it has to satisfy. The first condition is the payment is required. Here payment, by the term payment, what we mean is compulsorily it should be in monetary terms only. Okay, it is required by the law. It may be, the law may be created by the central government or state government or local government. Okay, when monetary system was not there, when barter system was there, kings used to collect tax from the farmers and from other persons, other professional persons, by way of the earnings that they have, by way of collecting what you call their paddy or wheat or whatever they produced, the farmers produced. From that produce, the kings used to directly collect a certain proportion. But now barter system is not there. So compulsorily everybody has to pay tax by way of money only. Okay. It is imposed by a government. Tax means it is compulsorily imposed by a government. Private persons, ordinary persons cannot collect tax, cannot impose tax. Imposed means levy. It is going to be imposed by, levied by, collected by a government. Okay. It is not tied directly. This is what you mean by saying indirect. The taxpayers amounts may be distributed among the entire society. So not tied directly to the benefits received by the taxpayer. In the previous class, I mentioned one example. I paid 10,000 rupees as income tax to the government last year. So in return, I may not get any amount from the government, any benefit from the government directly. Okay. as a society at large will be benefiting from my tax. Means the amount will be distributed. Now let us take for example, you must have watched in newspapers, in TV channels, the government is giving free vaccination to certain individuals. So the amount that is collected from my 10,000, from my pocket, that will be distributed to several persons across the society. So I am not going to get a direct benefit from the government. Various other persons may benefit from my tax payment. So that is what you mean by saying benefit is not directly related to taxpayer. He may not receive any benefit from the government at all, but he has to pay tax. So it is mandatory. It is imposed by government. And there is no direct benefit to the taxpayer. Okay. Now, next. See, there are various kinds of taxes. But today, we will strictly confine our discussion to direct taxes and indirect taxes. Okay. There are various other kinds of taxes are also there. But for the time being, in this class, we will confine our discussion. We will discuss about two kinds of taxes. One is direct taxes and the other one is indirect taxes. What is direct tax? What is indirect tax? What are the benefits, advantages of direct tax? What are the disadvantages of direct tax? Similarly, what are the advantages of indirect tax? What are the disadvantages of indirect tax? What are the differences between direct taxes and indirect taxes? These topics we will discuss. Okay. See, yesterday in my previous class, in the introductory class, I mentioned that I paid, I paid an amount of 10,000 rupees as income tax to the government. So this is an example of direct tax. Means there is no mediator. There is no broker between me and the government. Directly the person who has to pay tax is going to pay to the government in case of direct tax. Okay. So tax levied. Levied means imposed. Tax levied directly on the income or wealth of a person. Then it is called a direct tax. So in my case, in my example, this 10,000, I am paying directly to the government. There is no mediator. So that case, this tax is known as the direct tax. In a direct tax, please remember, tax is levied direct. Levied means imposed, charged directly on the person. Means on the income or wealth of a person. Okay, he is responsible directly to the government. He has to pay tax to the government. That tax is known as direct tax. Okay. Now, coming to next tax, indirect tax. See, maybe I hope at least one student has immediately went to nearby shop and purchased their notes for my income tax subject. I hope. Now you interact with me just a minute. Did anybody purchase special notes for income tax yesterday? Please, those who purchase special. Yes, very good. What is your name?
Trinu, sir. Trinu.
Sinu. Very good. Very good. Sinu. Now you tell me, what is the amount that you paid in the shop for purchasing notes?
Sir.
How much did it cost to you?
20, 25.
Very good. Very good. See, this 30 rupees a shopkeeper will collect from you. And in this 30, you do not know how much you are going to pay to the government. The shopkeeper is going to pay to the government. Maybe 5 rupees. This is just an example. This 5 rupees will go to the government by way of GST. That is goods and service tax. The notes that you purchased is a good. Okay. That 5 rupees, the shopkeeper will pay to the government on behalf of you. You will not pay to the government. The shopkeeper will make a payment to the government. That is indirect tax. Means you paid the 5 rupees to the shopkeeper. In the 30 itself, this 5 rupees is also there. But you are not paying directly to the government. The shopkeeper the seller, he will pay to the government. So that is known as indirect tax. That is an example of indirect tax. In case of indirect tax, the person who is ultimately responsible means the customer, he has to pay tax, but he will not pay directly. On behalf of the customer, the shopkeeper, the seller, the producer will pay to the government. Okay, you clearly understand the difference between direct tax and indirect tax. See, in direct tax, I have to pay 10,000. As income tax, I directly pay to the government. Whereas here, I just, in this example, Sino has purchased. Let another example be like this. I purchased notes worth 30 rupees. In this case, I have also to pay 5 rupees to the government by way of GST. So here I am not paying. I pay to the shopkeeper. See, here I am standing. Okay. I went to shop and purchased. Here I paid to the shopkeeper 30 rupees. Okay. Sandy, then he will collect 30 rupees from me. And in this one, he will keep 25 with him. And 5 rupees, remaining 5 rupees as tax, as GST, he will pay to the government. So this is an example of indirect tax. In indirect tax, see what happened? The shopkeeper paid to the government. But this 5 rupees originally, who paid? I paid. The customer paid. So I am paying indirectly to the government with the help of the shopkeeper. He is a broker here. He is the mediator here. So that is what we mean by saying indirect tax. In indirect tax, tax is levied on the price of a good. It means this is good. The notes is a good, is a commodity. So 30 rupees worth notes I purchased. On this one, on the price, I have to pay tax. And I could not pay, I did not pay. On behalf of me, the shopkeeper has paid. So that tax is known as indirect tax. Now, see, so that is the case with the indirect tax. So indirect taxes, in indirect taxes, the person paying the tax passes on the incidence to another person. In the previous example, I passed the incidence of tax to another person. Who is that person? Shopkeeper. Okay, the tax incidence is passed from one person to another person. I am the main person, but I passed the incidence, means original liability to pay tax, incidence means. Okay, original person who is paying here. So even though I am paying here, but I have passed the transaction to shopkeeper, he will pay to the government. So this is what you mean by saying indirect tax. Okay. So in direct case tax, we can give example as income tax. In indirect tax, GST, goods and service tax, is the example for indirect tax. Okay. Now let us discuss one small thing. Here, goods is there, service is there, tax is there. So tax we discussed in the previous class, we have discussed what is the meaning of tax. Now also we discussed, now coming to goods and services. Is there any difference between goods and service? Please, somebody should answer. Is there any difference between goods and service? Are both of them same? There is no difference?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay. Now you mute, I will explain. See, goods means there is a difference. Goods means they are visible to us. You can touch it, but services you cannot touch. See, let us take for example, gas cylinder is there. Okay. So this is a good. You can see the cylinder, but in gas cylinder, gas you cannot see, that is service. Okay. You cannot see it. You cannot touch it. Now, another example I will tell. See, in your house, electricity is there. Power is there. Okay, wires are there. From one switchboard to another switchboard, wires are connected. Okay. This is good. The electricity switchboards are goods. Wires are goods. But the passing of electricity, you cannot see. If anybody touches, the person will die. So that is a service. You cannot see it. You cannot touch it. There is a difference between goods and services. Goods can be seen. Goods can be touched. Service cannot be touched. Suppose if I am suffering from fever, I will go to doctor. What he will do? He will provide me goods or he will provide me service. He will provide me service. He will give injection or he will give a tablet. I will take it and I will get some relief from the fever. So that is what you mean by saying service. Service cannot be touched. There is a difference between goods and services. Okay. Did you understand, my dear students? Did you understand? Okay. So both are not the same. Okay. Now, see, this is the division of tax for our purpose, for this class purpose. Taxes are divided into two kinds of taxes, direct tax and indirect tax. See, here in case of direct tax, a person pays tax from his own pocket directly to the government. Example is income tax. So in case of indirect tax, person collects tax from customer and pays to government. Example is GST. Now I have mentioned the example. See, the person who has collected from me, shopkeeper has collected from me. I am the customer. Shopkeeper is the person. He has collected from me and he has paid to the government. This is what you mean by saying indirect tax. Okay. Now come to next. Our topic is, see, pros and cons means advantages. Pros means advantages. Cons means disadvantages. See, we will start with our discussion with direct taxes. See, in case of direct tax, advantages are equitable. Equitability will be there. Means in society, you have rich people and similarly, you have poor people also in society. So with the help of direct tax, the government collects more money, more tax from the rich persons. And the poor will not at all pay income tax. Okay. So do you know, interact with me now. Do you know how much percentage of the population is paying income tax in our country? Do you know? Out of 135 crore, 130 crore people, how many are paying income tax? Do you know? Can you guess what is the percentage? How much percentage of the population is paying income tax? Can you guess?
70%.
Yes, any other 70. Guess?
20%, sir.
Yes, any other guess? Okay, now you mute. I will tell. Around 1% is paying tax. Please remember. Income tax is paid by only 1% of the people in the country. Remaining are not at all paying income tax. Means in our country, out of 130 crore, only 1% means hardly 1 crore to 2 crore. In between 1 crore to 2 crore, they are paying taxes, income tax. Remaining are not at all paying income tax. See, the government is trying to lessen the gap between richness and poorness in the country with the help of direct tax. Means all will be, if the government increases income tax slab rates, income tax collection from the rich people, what happens? Automatically, all people will become equal at a certain stage. That is one of the aims of direct tax. Means the more amount can be collected from rich and the amount may be distributed by various means to the poor people in the country. So automatically at some stage, equitability, equality can be achieved with the help of direct taxes. That is one of the advantages of direct tax. Means poor people's capacity can be increased with the help of money collected by way of tax from the rich persons. See, you can see the government has initiated various schemes. Just let us take, for example, monsoon season will start in 1 week. Raitu Bandhu scheme is there. What the government is doing? Freely government is distributing based on the farmers' land, agricultural land, how much a person is having, how much an agriculturist is having, how much a farmer is having. Based on that, the government is distributing money to the farmers. So by way of distributing like this, the government wants to equate rich people with the poor persons in the society. So that is one of the advantages of direct tax. See, it is economical. Economical means cost is very low. That is what you mean by saying economical. See, government, there is no mediator involved in direct tax. Directly, I am paying my tax. Directly, I am paying to the government. Means there is no broker involved. There is no mediator involved. There is no commission required. Directly, I am paying. Means collection costs will be very less in direct tax. That is one advantage of direct tax. See, the tax is certain. Certain means there is no ambiguity. It is clear how much I have to pay. I know it. How much the government will get? Government will is also clear. So there is no ambiguity. It is clear to the taxpayer as well as to the authority. They also know how much amount by way of tax is going to come from me. Government is also knowing. I am also knowing how much I have to pay. Similarly, at what time I have to pay, I know. At what time the government is going to receive from me, the government also knows. So there is a certainty in case of direct taxes. Okay. So it is elastic in nature. Direct taxes are elastic in nature. Elastic means in case of emergency, they can increase the tax. So now, over the last 1.5 years, you know, pandemic situation is there. The government requires more funds. So in that case, government may increase immediately direct taxes so as to increase the revenue. That is what you mean by saying elastic. Same, it is productive. Direct taxes are productive. What do you mean by productive? Productive means they are, if certain community grows in numbers, and the return from them also will increase. Now let us take, for example, I will explain this with an example. Suppose, let us take, for example, in the society, doctors are there. Their income is more. Their financial capacity is more. I hope all of you agree. Okay. In the society, if doctors increase, automatically what happens? The taxes will also increase because their revenue will be more. Their income will be more. Automatically, taxes can be collected more from them by the government. That is what you mean by saying productivity. Okay, if in a society, if a certain community grows in numbers and prosper, prosperity means richness. So, as you all know, doctors are rich. Majority of the doctors are rich. That is a common notion. That is a common feeling in the society. If the number of doctors increases in the society, number increases, then that it will lead to increase in production. Here, production means tax revenue. Please remember, not physical production. So in this way, direct taxes will yield large revenue to the state. State means here, not only state government, central government, a country, it means. Okay. So like this. Then similarly, direct taxes are a means of developing civic sense. They develop civic sense. Civic sense is developed means, see, I know that I am a taxpayer in the country. Means I can proudly feel that I am helping the country becoming rich. Okay, means I know that I am helping the government. I am helping the poor people by paying the tax in time. So that is what you mean by saying civic sense. It develops civic sense. I am proud. Because I am a regular taxpayer, my payment is helping the country in becoming prosperous. So that is what you mean by saying civics is. If I do not pay tax, I know the consequences. Country's development will be hindered, will be going to face some problem. I may say face from some problem from the government. All these things I know means they are developing civic sense. So I behave as a responsible citizen. That is the greatness of direct tax. In my example, I mentioned your friend purchased 30 rupees worth book, but he does not know how much his GST is included in that book. That knowledge is not there. But in case of me, I know that I contributed 10,000 worth to the government. by way of tax. That I feel very proud for that. So that is what we mean by saying developing civic sense. Now, direct tax is a disadvantage. We have discussed the advantages of direct tax. Now we will discuss disadvantages. They are inconvenient. Means the person who pays direct tax is very, very, it causes inconvenience to the person. Okay. Nobody can help feeling the pinch. Pinch means it is a kind of suffering. See, when you are playing in your childhood, you play with somebody, means if you do any mistake, in your class also, if you do any mistake, your teacher will pinch you. Okay, maybe it causes some suffering to you. So in case of direct taxes also, they are very, very inconvenient to the people. They feel, why unnecessarily, see, I mentioned, see, your friends mentioned in the class just now, you thought that 20% of the people are paying a tax, 60% of the people are paying a tax, some told 70% are paying a tax. But it is only 1% or around 1% only are paying tax. Means, see, how the taxpayers will feel, see, because of we only, the rest of the 99% are enjoying with our money. That is the feeling of the majority of the taxpayers, my dear students. Okay. So that is an inconvenience that causes inconvenience to the taxpayers. See, avoidable tax, it leads to tax evasion. Means, see, only government employees income is fixed, is known by the government. Rest of the citizens, they can easily evade tax by various means. Suppose, let us take for example, a person is selling what you call samosas on railway platform. Let us take for example, now you interact with me. Will anybody, any samosa seller maintain any record of his sellings? How much his income is there? How much he is spending? Will he maintain any record? Please interact with me.
No, sir.
No. Actually speaking, his income is more than my income in some cases. But will he pay any tax? He will not pay any tax. It leads to evasion, tax evasion. Means, he will not pay tax. He will just get off from this tax structure. He will evade tax. Means he will submit a false return. He will not at all submit any return to the government. Return means a statement showing that my income is this much, my expenditure is this much, this is my savings. Every income, every expenditure, every saving, if that is reported in a statement, that is return. Okay, so he will not submit any return to the government. Okay, see, actually, so that is why direct tax is a tax on honesty. I am honest. I exactly tell that my income is this much. That is why I am going to pay this much tax. I am very clear. I am clearly mentioning, means I am being punished by the government for my honesty. Okay, so tax evasion means they just do not pay tax. Evasion means do not pay. In this case, okay, then arbitrary direct taxes are arbitrary in nature. Arbitrary means they are not fixed. So every year, you know, Union Finance Minister submits a budget in the parliament. Now, who is the present finance minister? Please interact with me at the central level. Who is the present finance minister? Who is the finance minister? Please interact with me. Who is the present finance minister? At the center, who is the finance minister? Nirmala Sitharaman G is our finance minister, present finance minister. Do you know? Have you heard any news? But now we have forgotten. Okay.
Yes, sir.
You have to remember, she is the present finance minister. So, how much a taxpayer should pay, it depends on her decision ultimately. So only a single person it is deciding. the entire country's tax structure, that is arbitrary. That is according to the whims and fancies of her, we are paying taxes. So that is what you mean by saying arbitrary, that is not fixed. Every year tax structure will change. This year one rates are there, next year the rates will change. Okay, so very, very direct taxes are very, very arbitrary in nature. They depend solely on the whims and fancies at the discretion of the finance minister. Okay, similarly, then we will discuss about indirect taxes advantages in our next class. Okay, indirect taxes advantages about this we will discuss in our next class.